Hello everyone and welcome to another video. Today I'm going to talk about VRAM and how much of it do you need for gaming. This video will be longer than usual videos and there are a lot of stuff to talk about when it comes to VRAM, so I'd strongly recommend you to watch it till the end so you don't miss out any important points. Let's start with VRAM or video memory. VRAM is a memory built in your graphics card which stores data for your display. It works just like how RAM and CPU works. It keeps the graphics card fed with all the information to render images for your monitor. So the question comes up, why can't you use standard memory for VRAM? Well, because it's much easier and faster for the graphics card to store and pull data out of the VRAM compared to standard memory or RAM. Now before finding out how much VRAM you need for gaming, let's take a look at the factors that influence VRAM usage. The first thing to consider is your monitor resolution. A 4K monitor will require more VRAM than a 1080p monitor. It's because a 4K monitor will have a lot more pixels and information to render almost 4 times than a 1080p monitor, resulting more VRAM usage. So lower resolutions equal lower VRAM usage and higher resolutions equal higher VRAM usage. At number 2 we have anti-aliasing and textures. Anti-aliasing like 4x MSAA and 8x MSAA requires a lot of VRAM. Also high quality textures use up a lot of VRAM as well. These are the main things that have great impact on VRAM usage. Now before going down to the numbers, let me clear a few important things for you. More VRAM doesn't mean better performance always unless your games need that extra video memory. Say you have a 2GB GTX 960 and your games require 1.5GB of video memory. So adding 2 more gigabytes of VRAM will not improve the gaming performance at all. On the other side of the coin, if you run out of VRAM and the games require more, your gaming performance will decrease immensely and there will be a huge drop in FPS. Also having more VRAM won't make a better graphics card if it doesn't have the juice or hotspot to render all the high graphical images at a decent frame rate in the first place. So putting 4GB of VRAM in a budget graphics card like the GTX 750 will not make any difference in gaming performance because it doesn't have enough horsepower to run the games at quality settings to use 4GB of VRAM. An example of more VRAM doesn't mean more performance can be the R9 390. The 4GB GTX 980 performs better than the 8GB R9 390 in games. It's because GTX 980 has more horsepower or graphics rendering power compared to the R9 390. Now as you're clear about all the stuff, let's get down to the numbers. How much VRAM you need depends completely on what games you're going to play, at what settings, and most importantly at what resolution. A couple of years ago I'd say that a GPU with 2GB of VRAM would be more than enough to play games at 1080p. But as games started to have more details and better graphics with time, the VRAM usage has increased a lot and many games have started to use more than 2GB of VRAM memory at maxed out settings at 1080p. Games like GTA 5, Witcher 3, Middle Earth, Shadow of Mordor use more than 3GB of VRAM at high settings and high quality textures with anti-aliasing at 1080p. So playing these games at high settings and high resolutions will require much more VRAM than 2GB. That doesn't necessarily mean people having decent GPUs with 2GB of VRAM won't be able to play modern titles. Even the most GPU intensive titles will run just fine with a graphics card that have enough power to render the game with only 2GB of VRAM by just lowering a few settings. With all the confusions about VRAM, the good news is that usually most high-end cards come with more video memory compared to low-end cards. And finally, considering modern titles, I would say that 4GB of VRAM would be the sweet spot for 1080p and 1440p gaming. Also, if you find in a few settings and your GPU have enough horsepower, then you'll still be able to play all the games with a 2GB video card at 1080p anyways. If you are patient enough to watch the video up to now, then let me know by hitting that thumbs up button and I hope the video helped you in some ways to have a better idea about VRAM. Also, don't forget to subscribe for future computer tech videos like this twice a week and hopefully I'll see you in my next one.